Hallelujah, children. Praise God. Jesus is Lord. Even today, He is Lord. He's always Lord. He was Lord at the cross of Calvary. He is Lord in my life. He was Lord in the grave. And when he was going back to heaven, Jesus Christ was still Lord. And he is still Lord even today. And we give him all the glory, all the honor belongs to him. Praise God. We want to thank God for this wonderful day the Lord has made for us, the 13th day of March 2021. God has been faithful and kept us from January, February. We are now in March and we appreciate him. And we want to thank God because he loves children. Yes, he loves children and God wants children to learn about him. And we want to thank God for the teachings that our teachers have been giving us. And before we revise the topic of last Sunday, let's bow down our heads and pray. Hands put together, zip our mouth, and let us pray. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We want to thank you because we are here before you, Father. We want to thank you for the day you have made. We want to thank you for the things we have been learning, O God, and we want to thank you for what you are going to learn today. May you receive all the glory, all the honor. You are worthy of praise, O God. Holy Spirit, come and take control, that I may decrease and you may increase. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And everybody says, Amen. How many watched last Sunday's preaching? You did? Yes, you are good children. I know you are always good children. What was the topic you were talking about? You remember? Yes, it was about the story of Jairus, trusting in God, trust and believe. Me, I watched it. It was only believe. You trust and then you only believe what the Lord does. And that is what Jesus did for the daughter of Jairus. The daughter of Jairus had just died and people were crying. And Jesus saw them and Jesus felt pity for them. He had compassion on them and Jesus went and talked to that girl that was dead. Jesus told that girl, wake up. And the baby woke up. And Jesus Christ, they trusted in Jesus Christ. And many people were not trusting in Jesus Christ from that day. They started trusting in Jesus Christ. They started believing in Jesus Christ. And we want to thank God for that. How many are still trusting in Jesus? Like Teacher Hamala, it was Teacher Francisca who taught us. She told us about the daughter of Jairus, how he was risen from the dead. And we want to thank God for that. We want to thank God for that. Bwaneswa Sifiwe. And who knows my name? Mwangapo nanijua. Last Sunday it was Teacher Francisca. Today is teacher who teaching you? Teacher Grace. And I know you don't always forget with my name because my name is the grace of God. When you pray that prayer, you remember my name. I am Grace, the grace of God. Bwaneswa Sifiwe. And today we have a new topic. God has given us a new topic. And our topic today is we are the light of the world. And you are going to read. How many have their Bibles? Your Bibles, bring your Bible, your notebook, and you should have a pen or a pencil. Today I have a pencil that I am writing with. You should have a Bible, a pencil, and a notebook where you're going to write. And I want us to write, the topic of today is, we are the light of the world. I'm also going to write, we are the light of the world. That is our topic today. And the date today is, let me write the date somewhere here. Today is 14th. Okay, 14th March. Somebody has just told me it's 14th, 2021. This is our day today, and you are going to learn about we are the light of the world. We have been called to be the light of the world. Who knows what a light is? A light. Light ni nini? kunakuanga na light kunakuanga na light mingi kama mimi leo niko na hii light ya torch, niko na hii light ya candle, niko na hii light ya bulb. Hii light yangu ya bulb ukiweka hivi itawaka. Niko na hii light ya bulb, mnaiona? Kuna lights mingi zenye zinatupatia nini? Light. Light inatumika kutupatia mwangaza, to shine in the darkness. And I want us to learn about the light, why we are the light of the world. Why are we the light of the world? You know, when Jesus Christ came first into the world, we were sinners. You see, we were dark as these beads of mine are. We were dark like this. Our hearts were dark like this. And then Jesus Christ came and he washed us with his blood. The blood of Jesus is this color red. You see this red? This is the blood of Jesus. It is red and it washes us. And when the blood of Jesus washes us, we become white and we become clean. We are as white as now the blood has washed us. And when we are washed, we start growing in the Lord. Green stands for growth. We start growing in the Lord and we become children of God. And today the Bible tells us that we are the light of the world. And we want to read from the Bible. Why are we the light of the world? Why are we the light of the world? Because Jesus Christ came, Jesus found our hearts dark, he washed us with his blood, and we become white. And when we become white, we become the light of the world, and we start growing. That is why we are the light of the world. Let us read from the Bible. Open your Bibles. I'm opening mine. In fact, mine is already open. Me, I'm ready to learn. Are you ready to learn? Open your Bibles from the book of Matthew, chapter 5, from verse 14 to 16. And I am going to read. And I want you to know that God is telling us that we are the light of the world. Bwana Yesu asifiwe watoto. Sisi ni mwangaza. Light inaitwa in Kiswahili, mwangaza. Tumeona there are so many types of light. But now, Jesus Christ is calling you the light. Kuna lights nyingi. Na hata wewe pia, wewe na mimi, Yesu anatuambia sisi ni light. Let us learn how we are lights of the world. The book of Matthew chapter 5. From verse 14 to 16, I will read. You are like light for the whole world. A city built on a hill cannot be hidden. No one lights a lamp and puts it under a bowl. Instead, he puts it on the lampstand, where it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, your light must shine before people, so that they will see the good things you do and praise your Father in heaven. The Bible tells us that we are the light. And when we are the light, if I light this one, it's telling me that if I am the light of the world, and I light my this light, and I put it under, are you able to see it? You cannot. If it's under, you cannot. So as the light of God, we should always be on top. People should see us because God is using us to light the world. The world is so dark and God is using you and me to light the world. And therefore, our light should always be on top, not under the table. The Bible is telling us that we put it on the lampstand, not under the lampstand. Any light, hata wewe ukiakisha candle, you see, I have a candle. Sio kama hii nikiakisha ita nini? Itazima. Let me try. Ona tu wenye lights zinawaka. Mnaona hii light yangu ya candle? Hebu ona light yangu ya candle. Saizi si mnaona inatoa light? Usiku, hii itakuonyesha hata njia. Lakini hii light nikiweka hapa inawaka vizuri. Ninaweza kuona hizi vitu nisome. Ninaweza hata kusoma nayo Bible. Lakini nikiweka hapa anda na ni usiku, will I be able to read the Bible? I will not be able to read the Bible if I put it under the table. So the light should always be on top of the table. Usichome vitu zetu. So, I want us to learn something. If we are the light of the world, we have some things that will always make the light of God not to shine. There are things that will make the light of God not to shine. And we are going to learn about these things. And we are also going to learn about How we should keep the light of God shining. What are the things that make the light of God to go off in our lives so that our lives will not shine? Let me see. I have, teacher, do you know one of them? If you know one of them, the things that make our light not to shine, and this one will always make our hearts dark. If we do them, our lights will not shine. If we do them, our hearts will be as dark as this. When we don't keep the light shining, our hearts become dark. Mnaona hii? Our hearts zetu, mioyo zetu zinakuwa nyeusi tititi. When we don't let the light of God shine, when we don't put it on top, it will, our hearts will go dark. There are so many things that make our lights to go off and makes our hearts to be dark. Number one, let me say, lying. Lying. When we lie, lying will make our hearts to be very, very dark. We should learn to speak the truth. When we speak the truth, the light of God will shine and God will be happy. But when we lie, our hearts will be like this. Very dark. But when we speak the truth, our lights will shine. Eh? You see the light? The way it is shining, our lights will shine when we speak the truth. How many are promising that we are going to speak the truth? We are going to speak the truth. Yes, we are going to tell the truth. Hata kama kiboko inakuja, tuonge ukweli. Tusiseme uongo. Si ndio watoto? Eh, tukue watoto wenye wanafanya light ya Mungu is shine. Another thing, healing. Nilikuwa kwa klasi ya class B nikawauliza ati wangapi wanaweza kuua? Wakasema mimi siwezi kuua. Mimi siwezi kuua. Kuua ni dhambi. Nikawauliza na wangapi wanaweza kudanganya? Wakasema inamaanisha hawawezi kuua na hawawezi kudanganya. But hizi dhambi mbili, mwenye amedanganya na mwenye ameua, wote wanaenda wapi? Hell. Wanaenda kuchomeka forever and ever. Sasa tusikwe wenye wanafanya dhambi. Let us not be, we should not kill. Killing will make our hearts to be dark. Another one is unforgiveness. Unforgiveness. If you don't forgive others who have wronged you, God will not forgive you. God in heaven will not forgive you. Biblia inatuambia aje, if you don't forgive others, God will not forgive you. So we should not keep unforgiveness in our hearts. It will make our hearts to be dark. And God does not like darkness. That is why anatuita light. Na sisi ndio light yenye Mungu anashine. Anatumia kushine the world by doing good things. So we should not be, our hearts should not be dark. We should not be stealing. Usiibe sukari ya mami. We should not steal. Hii inafanya hati yetu inakuwa dark. We should not steal. Eh? Eh, you're just telling ya kusteal. Kusteal nile mamia hata aliweka pesa ingine mahali. Mamia meficha pesa yake hapa chini. Wewe umeenda umechukua. Umeenda umenunua nayo nini? Chip. Ukisha nunua chip, mamia atauliza, nani amechukua pesa yangu hapa? Eh, unajua already hiyo ni stealing. Alafu utasema, mami si mimi. Hiyo umesha steal, alafu tena unaanza kulai. Unajua hizo ni dhambi yenye Mungu apendi. It makes our hearts dark, nyeusi, titi. Na hiyo Mungu apendi kama hearts zetu ni dark. Mungu anapenda kama hearts zetu zina shine. So we should not steal. Wangapi hawata steal tena? Eh? Usichukue raba ya mwenzako kwa class, usichukue pensili ya mtu, hiyo ni dhambi Mungu hataki. Stealing ni dhambi, ina make our hearts dark. Kuna vitu nyingi, ningeziandika zote, hebu niandike moja hapa, bullying. Wengine wanapenda kubuli wenzao, bullying. Kubuli ni kufanya nini? What is it to bully? Bullying others, kuchonga watu wengine, eh? Mtu hataja kuchokoza, na wewe unaenda sasa ndio unamnyang'anya bagi yake, alafu unaenda kurusha hata kwa matope ama kwa maji. That is bullying. God knows not. It makes our hearts to be dark, very dark. Mungu hapendi hiyo. So, we should try and be good children. We should not abuse others. It makes our heart dark. And yet, abusing. And yet, Biblia inatuambia nini? The Bible tells us that we are the light of the world. And if we do bad things, it's making our hearts dark. Eh? When it makes our hearts dark, eh? God is not happy with us. And it is sin before God. Slandering, fighting. Wangapo napenda kufight? Fighting. Munaona hii fighting? Nye munapigananga too.
hizo ni dhambi. Mkishapigana, ukipiga mwenzako utamumiza, alafu labda damu itatoka. Kuna vitu nyingi, pride, rudeness, eh? Ukikuwa rude, disobedient, hii lazima niandike. Wenye wana disobey, do not disobey, disobedient ni dhambi, eh? Inafanya hati yako inakuwa dark. Labda uliambiwa upanguze tu meza, eh? Alafu mamia ameenda huko nje kuchota maji. Mamia anarudi anapata kama hujapanguza meza ama hujaosha vyombo. That is umemdisobey. Na disobedience ni mbaya. Biblia inatuambia mwenye ana disobey hati yake ni kama hati ya mchawi. Ni hati nyeusi na kwa kama hati ya mchawi, and God does not like that. Now, these are so many things. These things, they make our hearts to be dark. Lying, killing, unforgiveness, fighting, stealing, bullying others, abusing, and disobedient, being who disobey. There's so many rudeness, being arrogant, they make our hearts to be dark. Ebona tu ikitu. Nye mnapenda darkness? Mi sipendagi darkness hata kama kuna blackout. Na akisha tu light yangu rakaraka ndio nione nayo. Una tuwa, inaiwekanga tu hivya lafina waka. Because darkness ni mbaya. So there are things that we need to do that God will help us, that we shall do, we will do those things, and we will be the lights that will shine for God here on earth. What are these things that we should do? The things that we should do, how to keep our hearts clean, how to shine the light of God. Our next is how should we shine, how should we shine as the light of God in the world, because the Bible tells us we are the light of the world in the world. How should we shine as light of God in the world? Can someone tell me how we should let the light of God shine, and this light should be put on top? Tulisema tusiweke chini, tusikue chini huko, tukue on top, because our light will shine on top. How should we do that? Me, I know one thing. By reading the word of God every day. When I read the word of God, it will teach me so many things. It will teach me not to sin. It will teach me how I should walk as a child of God, what I should do as the light of the world to shine the light for God in the world. We have been called to be the light of the world. So, by number one, reading the word of God every day. By reading the word of God, you read. By reading the word. Not just the word of God. By reading the word of God every day, unasoma kila siku, una make sure umesoma, so that you may feed your spirit. When you read the word of God, utapata inakuambia, usifanye dhambi, itakuteach about the 10 commandments, na hautafanya dhambi. Munajua hivyo. Sasa nitakana unasoma hiyo word every day, every day, every day. Another thing that we should do to let the light of God shine. Eh? We are the light of the world. We should not do what? We should not fight. Do not fight. Don't fight. Eh? When you don't fight, mtu amekuja tu amekuchokoza. Wengine mtu akikuja amekusukuma hivi, wewe pia unamsukuma. Anakusukuma, unamsukuma. Next itakuwa nini? Doof, doof, doof. Mmeanza kupigana. Na Biblia inatuambia sisi tusipigane. Sisi si kama wale watu wenye wanaishi in the darkness. Sisi ni watu wenye wanaishi in the light. And when the light of God is shining, if we do good things, huyu mwenye amenichokoza ninamwacha tu, alafu ninamsamehe, ninamforgive. And then if I forgive them, the light of God will shine. Chwa. Light ya Mungu itashine tu hivi. Nikifanya the right thing, the light will always shine. If I do the right thing, if I read the word, the light will shine. If I don't fight, the light will shine. If I pray, the light will shine. So when we do the right things, the light of God will always shine and shine and shine. Atutaona ile darkness, haitakuwa. Another thing, we should not steal. Do not steal. Don't steal. Eh? Hata ukipata mami amewacha hapa 10 bob ama 30 bob. Wachana tu na hiyo pesa hapo, eh? Hata ukipata alikuwa amewacha hapa kwa bahati mbaya imeanguka hivi. Usiseme umeokota, ulizie hii pesa ni ya nani, usichukue. Hiyo ikukua pesa yako na haujapewa. Na ukichukua utumie utakuwa mwizi. Na Biblia inatuambia ukikuwa mwizi hati yako inakuwa dark. And if you don't steal, what will happen? You will shine. Because you are the light of the world, you will shine. Every time you do the right thing, you shine. Every time you do the right thing, you do what? You shine. So, another thing that we should not do, that we should do to shine the light of God in the world. Eh? Another thing, hata nyinyi mnazijua, eh? I know you know them. We should not lie. Don't lie. Don't lie. Don't lie. Nimeandika vizuri kweli? Nimesahau hiyo spelling kidogo. Don't lie. Usiseme uongo. Tuseme tu ukweli na ukweli na ukweli. Na sisi ni light. Kama light ya Mungu, tuta shine. And don't do what? Obey. Always obey. When we obey, the light of God will shine. Obey. Tukue obedient children. Wakikwambia uoshe vyombo, mami aende mahali, arudi apate umeosha. Mami ameenda job anapata kwa sink imejaa. Unajua saa zingine pia tunajifanyanga vibaya. Mami ameenda town, wewe unangoja mami atoke huko amechoka, tena aanze kuosha vyombo. Umechafua vyombo zote. Alafu tena unawaachia mama ndiye aoshe. Shua ni watoto. Hiyo ni mzuri kweli? Saa zingine nitakana hata kabla ujambiwa ufanye, wenda tu ufanye. Usiongoje wakwambie kila kitu, osha vyombo, piga duster, osha nguo, apana. Saa zingine tu, enda tu mamia tafurahi. Akikuja, apate umeosha na hajakuambia. Mamia tafurahi, atasema, hey, mtoto wangu ni mzuri. Mtoto wangu ananisaidia kazi hata kama sijamwambia. Saa zingine, walianika nguo nje. Alafu mamia yuko, mvua imenyesha nguo. Na ni nguo zenye ungeweza kutoa kwa kamba. Imagine, unacha nguo zilishakauka, alafu tuna nguo zimekuwa baridi. Unajua hiyo ni dhambi na ni mbaya ukiwacha mvua inyeshe. Nitakana unasema, mvua isinyeshe nguo zetu, unaenda kwa kamba, unatoa pegs, unatoa, unazieka pale. Na ukifanya hivyo, mami will be happy with you. And remember, the light of God will always shine. When you do the right thing, the light of God will always shine. Ukitoa hizo nguo hata kabla hujaambiwa, usiongoje tu watu wakwambie kila saa ati fanya hii hapana. Saa zingine unafanya tu hata kama hujaambiwa. Alafu ile yenye uliambiwa ulipewa ufanye, unaobei, unafanya, alafu mami atafurahi. Na Mungu mwenye ako huko juu mbinguni atafurahi, atasema surely huyu mtoto wangu mwenye anaitwa Magi ni mzuri, anafanya light yangu ina shine kwa the world, anafanya tu vitu mzuri. Ona sasa hii anaosha vyombo na mama yake hajamwambia aoshe. Huyo ni mtoto mwenye anawacha light yangu ina shine. Na tukiwacha light ya Mungu ina shine, Mungu atafurahi. Another one, praying every day. When we pray every day, the light of God will shine. How? When we pray every day, the light of God will shine. Shetani hata, unajua shetani akuangi mali watu wanaomba. Unajua hivyo saa zile umepiga magoti hivi, unataka kuomba Mungu. Oh, shetani ameshatoroka. Useme tu, najifunika na damu ya Yesu. Shetani hawezi kukua hapo. And what will happen? When we pray, the light of God will shine. So we should pray every day. Ayawa. Mkonangu inateleza. We should pray every day and every time. Hata saa zile unatembea unaenda shule, useme najifunika na damu ya Yesu. Hata saa zile umekaa kwa class, najifunika na damu ya Yesu. Alafu exams wameleta ufanye, ambia Holy Spirit, nisaidie kukumbuka vitu zenye nilifanya nini, nilikuwa nimesoma, na zile zenye mwalimu alitufunza. Ukiomba hivyo, the light of God will shine and darkness haitakuwa. So we should always try and do the right things, so that what happens? The light of God may shine in the world. Biblia inatuambia, we are the light of the world. Verse 16 inasema, in the same way, your light must shine before people. When you are doing the right thing, your light is shining before people. And when the light is shining before people, what will happen? The Bible says, so that they will see the good things you do.
when you, they see, when people see the good things you do, the light of God will shine, and it is shining in the world. And it is telling us also, when the light of God shines in the world, they will praise your God in heaven. Well, they will praise your Father in heaven when you do the right things. There are so many right things that we are supposed to do as children. When the light of God shines, God will always be happy. People will see you. Now, atasema, huyu ni light of God kweli. Biblia inatuambia, when the light of God will shine, people will praise our Father in heaven. Sasa zile light yako ina shine, sasa zote light yako ina shine, people will praise who? Our Father who is in heaven. So we should always let our light shine. Kuna wimbo inatuambia, I'm the light of the world. I'm the light of the world. I shine the light of God upon the earth. Hebu tuimbe na nyinyi. I'm the light of the world. I'm the light of the world. I shine the light of God upon the earth. When you shine the light of God upon the earth, God will be happy. People will also praise the name of God in heaven. There are so many good things that will make the light of God shine. And there are also things that will make the light of God not to shine. So we should do which ones? These ones that will make the light of God to shine. There are so many. Don't fight, don't steal, don't lie. Read the word of God, obey, pray every day. They will make the light of God to shine. And when the light of God shines, the Bible tells us that people will see the good things you do, verse 16, and they will praise the name of our Father. And when our light is shining, if Jesus Christ comes and finds your light shining, we will go with him where? To heaven. How many wants to go to heaven with Jesus when he comes? Me, I want to go, because that's why I want to let my light to shine and shine and shine, so that I may go with Jesus Christ to heaven. The Bible tells us when our light is shining, we become holy. When we become holy, Jesus Christ is coming for us to take us with him to heaven. Jesus Christ will not take people who have a dark heart. No. Jesus will take the people whose lights are doing what? Shining every day and every time. Praise the Lord, children. I want us to read our memory verse for today. It is very simple. Na nataka uishike. Our memory verse says, can you read with me? Memory verse. It comes from which book? The book of Matthew, chapter 5, verse 14. You are the light of the world. Can you read with me? You are the light of the world. Sasa sema, I am. I am the light of the world. I am the light of the world. And you know, children, only those whose lights are shining are the ones who will go to heaven. And I want you to remember something. Always remember, the light of God should always shine. You are the light of God that God is using to shine in the world. Always remember to shine in the world. And remember also, when you do the right thing, God is recording and your light is shining. Always remember that God is recording everything good that you do, and even the bad ones. So we should choose to do the good things, so that ile kitabu yetu iko binguni iwekwe tuna records mzuri mzuri mzuri, because God is keeping our records. We should also remember that when we shine our light, we become holy. And when we become holy, Jesus Christ is coming for us. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Let us remember that we are the light of the world, the light that God is using to shine the world. Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Aya, we are going to pray. I hope you are remembering our memory verse. It is telling us that we are the light of the world. Let us bow down for a word of prayer. Father, we thank you. We give you all the glory. We want to thank you because the Bible tells us in Matthew chapter 5 from verse 14 to 16 that we are the light of the world. That when our light will shine, when we do the right things, our light will shine. And when our light will shine, people will see the good things we do. And when they see the good things we do, Father, the Bible says that they will praise you in heaven. They will say that these children are surely the children of the living God who is in heaven. Father, we pray that you will teach us to put your word into practice. Holy Spirit, help us and give us power over sin. When you give us power over sin, we will be able to shine the light of God in the world according to how it is written. Father, we thank you and we give you all the glory. May you be with us. May you continue being with us. May you continue teaching us. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Thank you.